Hi, welcome back to Secrets of the Red Carpet. We're here in the chat room with Jenny Wu, Molly Quinn, and the amazing and talented Alana Pratt. So Alana, we have a few questions, I believe, coming into the boards.
We have so many questions. Before I start, I get to hear what everybody says about both of you, and they adore both of you. Oh my God, what you wearing, and what are her favorite shoes? So there's some real, like, girlfriend talk that we want to go into before some of the deeper questions. So just favorite outfits, designers, shoes, and then it's your turn. We'll get that out of the way for you.
I really wish you'd go first because I love your style. And getting to hear you, it's incredible. I can't wait to check out your blog. So please.
Thank you so much. Okay. Wow. That's a lot. Do we have, like, how much time do we have?
30, 40 minutes.
You get one designer, Jenny.
Okay. Right now, I would say my favorite designer is Yigal Azarel. He has this new diffusion line coming out called Cut 25, and it's just the most amazing, most wearable pieces.
For people that don't look like you, because look at both of you, you're both like, whoa.
No, I mean, it's, you know, he does a lot of beautiful knits and cashmere and tailored jackets, so I think it's just very complimentary on everybody.
Feminine, nice. Mm-hmm.
I love Ralph Lauren. Yeah. I think he's timeless. I've never seen anyone look bad in Ralph Lauren, and for me, I think I've probably worn Ralph Lauren since I was a child. So
you're still a child.
I'm still a child. Well, I keep having to remind myself of that. But so
I'm just teasing.
For me, no, it's true. I really sometimes I'm like, you're not 30. You're not 30.
But you have 18. A very old soul, and the way you show up is quite impressive, wouldn't you say?
Oh, definitely.
Well, yeah, you've been having to be on camera and be in the limelight for a while. So
It's been great, and it's been a huge blessing.
And you're a fairy.
Someone said,
oh, she has wings.
I really wish that we would do a clothing line. I want Winx to have a clothing line so bad.
That would be awesome.
It's perfect for young girls. It's cute. It's sassy. I mean, some of the midriffs, you know, parents might not want their girls to wear. We would fix that up, but I think it'd be a great idea. So
I think that's a great subject. It kind of brings in some of the questions that have been coming in about younger women dressing, trying to be enough, trying to be too sexy versus just enjoying the journey of being a confident feminine. And you were even, what were you saying about some of these empowered Comic-Con women? Like, strong.
Strong. Right? I mean, I think that all girls need to dress their age because there's great things with every age. You know, don't try to hurry up and wear spike-heeled shoes and tons of makeup if you're a 15-year-old girl. Enjoy that. You know, put on some sneakers, put on a nice little skirt, you know, light makeup. Mm. I really think that because you know, time flies and you're going to get to do that. So don't waste any moment of your life. Be who you are and embrace it. Enjoy it. Love your age.
Exactly. And I think beauty comes from the inside. And when you feel confident and beautiful on the inside, it really shows. So like Molly said, enjoy who you are and live in the moment and be present in that. Mm-hmm.
We've got some empowered women here on Power TV. Go the distance. So we started with young. Go later. She's feeling older. Mm-hmm. She's not feeling as sexy as the girls before. And sometimes women, when they get older, they also overcompensate versus really shine from the inside out as a seasoned, like a fine wine. Mm. What would you say to an older woman that wants to still be feminine but not look like she's trying too hard?
Well, I think it's really important to have the right bra. Number one, that's a huge help, which is the foundation of any outfit and actually changes your shape. So it's the starting point.
I agree. And, you know, play with the classics. I think a beautiful tailored button-down blouse with a nice pencil skirt just works on everybody. And, you know, play with makeup too, because I think that can really change a look. And as you're getting older, you know, age gracefully. And, you know, be aware of your features and play up the features that are your favorite, whether it be your eyes or, you know, your shoulders or your asset, you know.
Right.
Play with that and really highlight what you're comfortable with. And I think that's just a great way to kind of age gracefully and to be stylish at every age. Mm.
And not being afraid to show your shape, too. I think it's really important to show your shape at any age and not hide from it.
I agree that there's going to be a different area of our body. We can focus on the part that's drooping, or we can focus on the part that's radiant. It's a choice, right? And you focus on what you love, then you really turn heads when you walk in a room.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So we have another question, then another question. They want to know about Hollywood. What's it really like? Are the women really competitive, or is there actually a nice kind of sisterhood going on, and they want the truth?
I think there's... I think women compete everywhere. I think that's part of us. Wherever you are, you'll be lucky if you find one girl that you can really be close with. And I think if you have that one friend, you've got it made. So just build your little family no matter where you are, because people are always going to try to there's always someone better than you. There's always going to be someone with bigger eyes, better hair. You will never be the absolute best. I mean, that's just the truth. So love who you are, have your support group, and then you'll shine wherever you are, being Hollywood or
high school,
North Dakota or high school or wherever you are.
Beautiful.
Now, Molly's really lucky, too. Molly has an amazing family that's very supportive and really, you know, works with her and I think allows her to shine and really fly.
This is true. Without my family, I would not be the person I am.
Beautiful. Mm. And you, with your changing from the fashion lawyer to the fashion blogger, they're wondering about, did you feel kind of stifled before and now really fully self-expressed to say the truth? Or was there any connection there when you left?
Well, you know, I grew up in a very conservative household. And for me, when I was thinking about career choices when I was young, I didn't really think that there was much option outside of kind of working in the corporate world, which is why I took up law and I, you know, followed that step and didn't really consider other options. And it wasn't until I became a lawyer that I realized, you know, there's so much out there. And honestly, as long as you're passionate about something, you can be successful doing whatever it is that you wanted to do. And I quickly realized that my passion was in fashion. Mm-hmm. And I knew that life was too short, and I had to make sure that I was doing something that I loved to do every single day. And that's why I made the transition from law to fashion. And I am so happy that I did that.
I can see it.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
I think that we're wrapping up.
Oh, but they have a question for Luke. Just one. Do we have
just a quick one? Quick,
this
really one, fast.
This lady about your cardiac event.
Yes.
About she wants to get exercising and go swim like you, but she's ashamed because she's big.
Okay. I understand this. You're about the bathing suit.
The bathing suit.
Oh, I totally get this. Yeah. Nothing was more terrifying to me than weighing 60 pounds more than I do now and standing around in front of a lot of swimmers who are fit people in a tiny little piece of spandex.
Yeah.
And at first I wore the big board shorts.
Yeah.
And the coach said I had to stop wearing the sea anchor to swim in. Mm. You know, swimming has really given me the body that I feel I'm supposed to have. Mm. You know, it's that kind of exercise. Rather than exercising to change the shape of something, I'm just exercising to kind of live. And it has rewarded me with the body I'm supposed to have and something I'm really comfortable in. You just got to do it. You just got to go with it and love who you are in whatever outfit and whatever shape you are. Because otherwise, what are you going to do? Not swim? Not go to the beach?
Confidence is the sexiest thing.
Confidence is sexy.
So you just see her flying like the little angel and you with your fashion and you with your great advice and just go for it.
So thank you. Thank you both so much. This has been a great session. I want to thank Jenny Wu from Good, Bad, and Fab and Molly Quinn from ABC's Castle and the
really
amazing
nice
beheaded
nice
Alana Pratt for another thank wonderful
you.
Chat session and thank another you. Great episode of Secrets of the Red Carpet, Style from the Inside Out. You can find us on demand at emPOWerme.tv/secrets. See you soon.